Hi Pisces, this is your November 22nd through November 28th weekly tarot reading. I do 5 separate spreads in my weekly readings. We'll have a spread on new love, a separate spread on love in an existing relationship or marriage. I'll do an X spread. We'll talk about your work, your business, and your finances, and we'll see what you're not expecting this week. Please like, subscribe, and share this video to support this channel. This first spread is on new love. This week, we have the Six of Pentacles, clarified by Justice. We have Death, clarified by the Fool. We have the King of Cups. In the potential outcome, we have the Queen of Cups with the Empress and the Hierophant. And we also have the Wheel of Fortune on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Libra or a Taurus or a fellow water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or another Pisces. This person coming into your life will change your life forever. And you realize it. You do realize it, that it's either now or never, or it kind of sounds like the two of you will have a conversation. The two of you will have a conversation and you'll tell them, you know what, if we do this, this better be good, this better be serious, this better lead to a commitment. And to a commitment it will lead. Right? We have both the King and the Queen of Cups in the same spread. Right there in the middle. We got the King of Cups in the main spread and the Queen of Cups in the potential outcome. So one of them is you. You assign the roles as you wish. And the two of you make a perfect loving couple. You know, they could be a fellow water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, or another Pisces. A Scorpio in particular, because we also have Death. The third card from the left, Death, is the personal Scorpio card. But they could be any sign, any zodiac sign whatsoever. But whenever a king and a queen of the same suit, and especially a king and a queen of cups come out, that means that the two of you belong together, the two of you are two lovebirds, you vibe on the same level, you basically belong together, right? You truly do belong together here. But it's going to take you some time to come to that conclusion. I do see you struggling a little bit. We have the Six of Pentacles clarified by Justice, the first two cards on the left. Justice is the personal Libra card. You could be dealing with a Libra. But what's symbolic about those two cards? We have scales in both of those cards. We got scales in the Justice card. In one of the hands, Justice is holding up the scales. And the person standing in the middle in the Six of Pentacles is also holding up the scales. So scales are all about balance, it's all about equal give and take, and it's all about pros and cons, it's all about doing what's right for you, right? So when this person shows up in your life, perhaps you'll, like I said, you'll have a very serious conversation after you do your deliberation. I think that's you trying to, you know, balance the scales, trying to figure out if this is something you want. But I think you're probably in your life, you don't have time to play around and fool around. You could be 20 years old and it could be your state of mind. You could be 60 years old, you could be 40 years old. But in your head, there's no longer room or time for you to waste your time. Right? This is what you firmly believe in. And that's what you will talk to them about. You'll tell them that if we do it now, it better be good. There better be a commitment. You better commit. I kind of see you. I kind of hear you saying that. You better be serious. You better mean what you're saying. You better be as solid as you say you are. You better deliver. Right, so Death, the next card that came out, it could be a Scorpio you're dealing with, but Death is this big transformation of your life. So if you do go for it, it'll be a huge transformation of your life for the better. The Death card is clarified by the Fool. The Fool is all about moving forward, taking a leap of faith, just believing that it's going to work out. What I always notice about the Death and the Fool card, both cards have a sun, right? Or the sun. In the Death card, it's in the middle on the right. There is a sun rising. And in the Fool, it's in the right bottom corner. So the sun and The Sun is the happiest card in the deck. If we were to look at the Sun card, I hope you know there is a Sun card in the tarot deck. The Sun is the happiest card in the deck, and the Sun in this cards represent the sunrise. So this is a new day of your life that is beginning with this new person. And I do believe this person realizes the seriousness of the situation, right? We have the King of Cups, as I already mentioned. It could be a water sign. We also have the Queen of Cups in the potential outcome. That could be you or them. And we also have the Empress with the Hierophant in the potential outcome. The Empress is probably the way they look at you. They do see you as somebody they want to spend the rest of their life with. They're putting you up on a pedestal. Besides that, the Empress is abundance in its purest form. The Empress is actually one of the most positive cards in the deck. And in my spreads, the Empress always shows up as a sign from above, a stamp of approval, so to speak, for a connection to move forward. Then we have the Hierophant. The Hierophant is the personal Taurus card. You could be dealing with a Taurus. Or the Hierophant is about something traditional like a committed relationship or marriage. So yeah, the potential is definitely there. I'm pretty sure the person you're dealing with, they get it. They get it that this is an important step for you, that they gotta be there for you. They gotta deliver. You know, this is the final step. This, it's either we get serious or we don't bother, right? They get it. The Wheel of Fortune on the bottom of the deck all the way to your right is the start of a new cycle, a very fortunate new cycle. The Wheel of Fortune is always good news in my spreads. I really like the fact that the Wheel of Fortune is here and it's on the bottom of the deck. So there's definitely a good, really fortunate cycle starting between the two of you. I do understand where you come from. Pisces, I'm feeling it, but rest assured, this person gets it. You will still have to talk to them and make sure the two of you are on the same page, and after that conversation, you will be resting assured that the two of you belong together, they get it, they understand the seriousness of the situation, and the two of you will be moving forward together. Yep, really happy for you, Pisces. Congratulations. Pisces, if you are already married or if you're in a relationship, this spread is for you. We have the Two of Wands clarified by the Two of Swords. We have the Five of Swords. We have the Six of Wands. And we also have the High Priestess on the bottom of the deck. A very specific message I have for you, Pisces. This will only resonate with you if your person started taking you for granted. They no longer give you flowers. They no longer do all those nice things they used to do for you. They basically relaxed, right? And you're not happy about it. You're really not happy about it. And this week, I kind of see it like an ultimatum. You're going to give them an ultimatum. Either you go back to the way you used to be and take care of me and do all those nice things for me and run the errands, take care of other things, or I'm out of here, right? And like I said, I don't think it's not your problem, right? It's them. They became this way. They started taking you for granted. They relaxed. They are no longer doing all the things they're supposed to do, or all the things they did, right? You're gonna win either way. Alright, so let's talk about this. The Two of Wands, the first card that came out, which is clarified by the Two of Swords. Actually, both cards are talking about the same thing. This is you at the crossroads, right? And I think this was something a long time coming, right? So perhaps you've been together for a while. So this week, you're making a decision to give him that ultimatum with the Two of Wands and the Two of Swords. You are at the crossroads, and you're going to put them at the crossroads as well. So the Five of Swords, this is a card of somebody who is walking away. The Five of Swords is a card of a fight. This is a card of severing ties in a sort of an ugly way. And I do see it as that ultimatum. You will basically tell them either do this, this, and that, or I'm out of here. Right? And like I said, you're going to win. The next card that came out is the Six of Wands. The Six of Wands is a card of victory. So if they do start doing what they're supposed to do, you will feel like a winner. Or if they say, no, I don't want to do this anymore, then you will be getting out of there and you'll still feel like a winner because you're not being treated the way this person is treating you now. The 601s also is all about you meeting somebody new at some point in the near future and feeling great about that. The High Priestess on the bottom of the deck, this is your intuition, right? So you intuitively know that you need to do this, because other than that, they will not get the point across. You have to give them that ultimatum. All right, so like I said, a very specific message, Pisces, but as I always say, we're in each other's lives to make each other's lives better. And if that doesn't happen, then we have the full right to pursue happiness someplace else. And that's exactly what you're doing. All right, cool. Let's see if anybody comes back from the past for you, Pisces, this week. Keep in mind, it could be somebody from a couple of months ago, a year ago, or a couple of years ago, so it doesn't have to be the most recent ex. We have Judgment, we have the Two of Swords, we have the Five of Pentacles clarified by the Four of Cups, and we also have the Sun on the bottom of the deck. Unfortunately, we didn't get any court cards, right? But it's not going to matter. Whoever this person is, whatever their zodiac sign is, the answer is going to be no. So whoever is coming back from the past this week, you're going to reject them. Judgment, the first card that came out, this is a card of somebody coming back from the past. Then we have, actually, the rest of the spread is you saying no. The Two of Swords is you remaining closed off. The Two of Swords is a big, fat no. Then we have the Five of Pentacles, clarified by the Four of Cups. The Five of Pentacles is a card of somebody feeling left out in the cold, somebody feeling miserable. So perhaps this ex will tell you a little sobby story, but you're not going to care. You're done with them, right? The Five of Pentacles is clarified by the Four of Cups. The Four of Cups is a card of a rejection, so you are rejecting them. We also have the Sun on the bottom of the deck. The Sun is the happiest card in the deck, so you could be happy with somebody else, you could be happy by yourself, but you're definitely happy without this person in your life. Right? Because you know that this person is not going to bring happiness into your life, and you're not going to care about their little sobby story. All right? You're sending them back to the past where they belong. Let's talk about your work, your business, and your finances, Pisces, this week. We have the Ace of Pentacles, we have the Ace of Swords, we have the Nine of Swords, and we also have the King of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. It's not a bad spread, Pisces, because you're really in high demand as a professional here. For some of you, you could have two equally good new job offers, and you're just not sure what you need to do here, right? We have the King of Pentacles on the right, on the bottom of the deck. It could be a person offering you this job, or it could be one of the people who works for one of the companies offering you a job, or it could be just one company offering you a job, but you're not sure if you should leave your existing job and accept this new job. The Nine of Swords right next to the deck, I think that's you, Pisces. You see how that person can't sleep at night? They've got anxieties, they are not sure what to do, they're unclear. But, you know, this job, if there's just one job offer, then this job offer is amazing. With two aces, you can barely ever beat that. They really want you. They'll pay you good. They'll do whatever it takes for you to feel comfortable there with those two aces. If you got two job offers, two equally good job offers, then it makes total sense. So I would just do your research. There's, I think, a website out there where employees or ex-employees leave comments and leave feedback about particular companies, so look it up or just do your research and make an educated decision. But if it's just one particular job, one job offer, then you know change is inevitable. It's gonna happen whether you want it or not. So I always say embrace it. You know, change is inevitable. So if this is a new job offer, take it. It's a golden opportunity with that Ace of Pentacles. All right, cool. Let's see what you're not expecting to happen, Pisces, this week. We have the Tower, clarified by the Knight of Swords. We have the Three of Cups. We have the Star. And we also have the Fool on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. I can interpret the spread a couple of different ways. Scenario number one, you could be unexpectedly invited to a party or an event or a gathering, and you're gonna go. Yes, you are gonna go. For others of you, you could be unexpectedly uniting with someone here. And this union could be based on love, it could be based on friendship, you could be making an amazing new friend, or it could be based on anything. It could be a union with a family member, somebody whom you were not really in touch with, but all of a sudden they showed up for your Thanksgiving dinner, and you know, the two of you connected to a new level. Right? So the Tower, the first card that came out, is, in this case, this is something that happens unexpectedly. That's exactly what the spread is about. The Tower is qualified by the Knight of Swords. Knight of Swords could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius. You're dealing with an Aquarius in particular, because we also have the Star right next to the deck. The Star is the personal Aquarius card. But it could be any air sign, or the Knight of Swords could be something that happens all of a sudden, unexpectedly. The Knight of Swords is the fastest knight out of all four knights. So what this could be about, like I said, is either you're invited to a party or a gathering or a union or some sort of an event. The Three of Cups, the next card over, it could be a party or an event or a gathering, right? Or the Three of Cups is a card of a union, a very happy union. We have the Star right next to the deck. As I already mentioned, it could be an Aquarius you're dealing with, or the Star is a wish come true. Perhaps you always wanted to go to this concert, and this person's got an extra ticket for you. Perhaps you always wanted to unite with this person, or you always wanted to, you know, have a party or go to that particular party if it happens repeatedly. And with the Fool on the bottom of the deck all the way to your right, this is you're either going to the party or an event or a gathering or a concert, or you feel great. You feel awesome about this union, about this celebration. So this is a pretty good, something unexpected, Pisces. Alright, so that's what I got for you for this week. If this video resonates with you, please like it. Please also share and subscribe. And other than that, Pisces, have an amazing week. And there you have it. This was your tarot reading for this time period. I hope it resonated with you and helps you live a better life one way or the other. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing.